I study life history trade-offs, so I'm interested in, so life history traits are things like how quickly do you die, how quickly do you senesce, how quickly do you grow, how many babies do you have, how quickly do they grow, how many babies do you have, and so trade-offs between those components. So do you have more babies or do you have fewer babies but bigger babies that grow more quickly? So those are called life history trade-offs, and I'm interested in the physiological basis of those life history trade-offs. So what are the traits in an organism's physiology mediating whether they're going to have lots of babies or they're going to have fewer babies, or they're going to grow really quickly or they're going to grow more slowly? And I'm interested in studying those questions using birds as a model system. So the students in my lab are working on different projects, but we're all working with birds. And so we work with birds in the field or in the lab. And I have two populations of birds that we're working with right now. So in the field, we work with eastern bluebirds, which are native species in Oklahoma. And then in the lab, we work with zebra finches, which are really common pet store birds. So people might have seen them at Petco, for example. They're birds that are not native here. They're native to Australia, but they breed really easily in captivity. And so that's why we like working with them. And so we're interested in physiological ecology and behavioral ecology questions. So looking at the physiology of an animal and the behavior of an animal within its natural environment. With zebra finches, we're doing slightly different work. So there we're looking at effects of stressors during development on how the nestlings develop. So if a nestling is exposed to stress hormones or is exposed to a disease during development, or if the mother is exposed to lots of stress or stress hormones or a disease while she's producing eggs, how does that affect her offspring? How quickly do they grow? How does their immune system develop? And what are their learning and memory responses like? So there's a lot of research with rodents that's shown that exposure to bacterial infection during development has a long-term effect on learning and memory, so that rodents that are exposed to bacterial infection during development have poor learning and memory responses as adults. And so we're interested in studying that in the zebra finches, and one reason they're a great system is because they exhibit vocal learning of their songs that's pretty similar to the way that we learn human language. So we can look at the way they learn song and how that's affected by stressors during development and how that's related to the way that humans learn their speech.